In this session, we will be talking about half subtractor. If you do remember, in the previous video segment, we had discussed a half adder and a full adder and its implementation. So similarly, we will first discuss a half subtractor, its truth table and implementation using logic gates. And then in the next segment, we will talk about a full subtractor. So here, when we talk about half subtractor, we have two binary bits, A and B, and since we are subtracting, there is difference and there is borrow. So you have two binary bits, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So these two bits have to be subtracted. So 0 minus 0, difference is 0. Borrow is 0. So here, when we talk about 0, 1, during binary subtraction, we had discussed this. So this number 0 minus 1, when we have to subtract 0 minus 1, this is a smaller number and this is the larger number. So we basically cannot subtract 0 minus 1. So you would get minus 1 here. But I don't want a negative number, isn't it? So what we do is we borrow 1. So when I borrow 1, it becomes 1, 0. 1, 0 in binary is equivalent to 2 in decimal. So this is 2 minus 1, which gives me 1. As the difference. So difference is 1, borrow is 1. Right? So how do we understand this? Suppose there is a number 1011. For easy understanding, let us discuss a decimal number. So we have, let's say, 7, 5, 4 and 9. So 75 minus 4, 9. So here I need to subtract 5 minus 9. So what do? We borrow 1 from the previous, we borrow 1 from 7. Now when I borrow 1, this becomes 15. Since we are operating in decimal, when I borrow 1, it basically means that I will be adding 10 to this number. Since in decimal we have 10 digits, 0 to 9. So when I borrow 1, I basically add 10 to this number. So we very conveniently put a 1 here. So when I put a 1 here, automatically we are adding 10. So 5 becomes 15. Right? So 15 minus 9, we get 6, and then you have 2 here. So similarly, when I do this subtraction, since we are doing subtraction in binary, you have 0, 1. So there are 2 digits. So when I borrow 1, I am basically adding 2 to this number, or it becomes 1, 0 in binary, which is equivalent to 2 in decimal. So 1, 0 in binary minus 1 is equivalent to me saying that it is 2 minus 1 in decimal, which gives me 1. Okay, so I get 1 as the difference and I have borrowed 1, so therefore I have 1, 1. So 0 minus 1 will give me 1, 1. So this is something which we need to remember. Next, 1 minus 0 is very simple. There is no borrow required. So difference is 1, borrow is 0. 1 minus 1, difference is 0, borrow also is 0. So once we write the truth table, we can write the algebraic expression for both difference and borrow. So when I observe, the truth table, difference is 1 for 0, 1 and 1, 0. Right? So this is nothing but the condition for XOR. So difference is nothing but A XOR B. Whereas borrow is A bar B. Right? So this is A bar B for borrow, and difference is AX or B. Right? So for complementary inputs, the output is 1. So the XOR is nothing but A bar B plus A B bar. So we can implement this using gates. So we have A B, A XOR B will give me difference. Next, I need A bar, so I pass A through an inverter, so I get A bar B, pass it through an AND gate, we get borrow. Right? Now the same thing can be implemented using NAND gates and NOR gates. So let us try to do that. So what is the condition for implementation using NAND gates? We very well know that we have to convert all sum to products. So I double complement this expression. So I get A bar B bar into A B bar bar the whole bar. Okay. So here there is no plus sign. So I retain borrow as it is. So we draw two parallel lines, A and B. Right? So you need to go through the previous videos wherein we have done implementation of all the gates using NAND and NOR. So this is XOR gate which has already been done. So I have A bar. So you get A bar by passing A to both the inputs of the NAND gate. And then B bar, pass B to both the inputs of the NAND gate. So what do we have? We have A bar into B, A bar into B, pass it through a NAND gate. So this is A bar B. So I get A bar dot B the whole bar. And similarly, A and then B bar. Pass this also through another NAND gate, so we have A, B bar, the whole bar. Right? So this is expression 1. And this is expression 2. So I have 1.2 the whole bar. So I have expression 1 here and expression 2 here. So I pass 1 and 2, expression 1 and 2, to the two inputs of a NAND gate, and we get the difference. Right? Next, borrow. So now we have A bar B, right? But I need to implement this using a NAND gate. So what do we do? So let me double complement this. So I have A bar and then B, A bar and B. So I pass it through a NAND gate. Okay, or A bar B is already there. If we do observe, we already have A bar B here, isn't it? When we implement the XOR operation, we already have A bar B. So I have A bar B the whole bar. So this expression is already there. So this expression is already there here. Okay, so that again has to be passed through an inverter. So I pass this through another inverter. So we get borrow. Right? Okay. So now let us try to implement the same thing using NOR gates. So for NOR gate implementation, I need to have all the terms right. So I need to have all the terms with a plus sign. right? So you have a bar b. So let me take the difference expression. So I have a bar b the whole bar into a b bar the whole bar and a bar on top. So let me apply De Morgan's rule here. So I get a double bar plus b bar into a bar plus b double bar, then a whole bar on top. So this would mean that I get a plus b bar, and then I have a bar plus b. Then applying De Morgan's theorem, so this is a dot b the whole bar. So I have a bar or term 1 dot term 2 the whole bar. So I get the first term complement plus the second term complement. So this is what we get. Okay, so similarly for borrow. So this is for difference. So for borrow we have a double complement plus b complement and a bar on top. So this simplifies to a plus b complement the whole complement. So this is borrow. So now we can implement the expression using NOR gates. So to make our implementation look better, draw two parallel lines A and B. So we need A bar. So pass A through both the inputs of a NOR gate. Again pass B through both the inputs of another NOR gate. So we get A bar and a B bar here. So what is the first expression? A plus B bar. So I have A plus B bar. Pass it through a NOR gate. So I get A plus B bar the whole complement. So next I have A bar plus B. So you take A bar and then B, pass it through another NOR gate. So I have A bar B. So we get A bar plus B the whole complement. So this is term 1 and this is term 2. I need 1 plus 2. So this is term 1 and term 2. So when I pass this through the NOR gate, so what happens? You pass this through a NOR gate, so we would get 1 plus 2 the whole bar. But we need 1 plus 2, again pass it through another inverter, which would give me 1 plus 2 itself, which is the difference. Now for borrow, I need A plus B bar the whole bars, right? A plus B bar the whole bar is here. A plus B bar the whole bar is here, and this becomes the borrow expression. Okay, so this is how we implement the difference and borrow using NOR gates. Okay, so in the next segment we will discuss a full subtractor, its truth table implementation using gates, implementation using NAND gates, as well as implementation using NOR gates.